No.
There's a qissa mentioned by the scholar, his name is At-Turkmani. At-Turkmani, he's a student from the students of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, little known by many, but he's famous at his time period. His name is At-Turkmani al-Hanafi. He has a book called Al-Lama' fi Hawadith al-Bid'ah. And this book, he brings on page 436 to 437 a qissa from one of his own teachers about an incident regarding the ghul. So I want to read this story because it's very interesting, but also the solution that he brought. He says one day, one of our mashayikh, he said, my shaykh, or one of our shuyukh, he told me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested him with this shayateen. He said a shaytan from the jinn would come and interrupt the sheikh when he used to do his qira'ah, his reading. And the sheikh used to curse it and used to belie and deny this shaitan. But this shaitan would be persistent. It would come to him at night and it would cause fear amongst the people by throwing rocks into the house. Can you imagine? Throwing rocks into the sheikh's house, ayyadu billah, and harming and stoning them. So what happened was the sheikh, he told At-Turkmani and his student, because he was a student of his, and he told them what's happening. And then he said that sometimes it would throw the rocks, and other times it would, subhanallah, it would, because the sheikh had a staircase in his house, and it had some nails, and the jinn would put the nails upwards so people can step on it and harm them, and he would actually throw them in their face. Astaghfirullah Azim. And then on top of that, he said, the sheikh said that he used to have a chest full of books, and the jinn would open the chest and throw the books in their face. And he would even take the sieve of his wife that she would use to sift the flour when baking, and he used to throw that in their face as well. Remember, this is happening in the house at night. So when the sheikh heard this, At-Turkmani and his companions, he told the sheikh, okay, tomorrow we're coming to your house, inshallah. وَنَقْرَأُ شَيْئًا مِّن كِتَابِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. We're going to read something in the book of Allah in there. So they came and they read Surah Al-Baqarah bikamaliha until the end of it. And then they made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect the shaykh from this jinn. He says, فَصَدَّ الْحَقَّ بِالشَّيْطَانِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the truth against the shaytan بِبَرَكَةِ الْقُرْآنِ, by the barakah of the Qur'an. And after that, the shaytan never came to the house again. Allahumma barak. This is a benefit that we want to narrate in relation to this. So we take an example from that. And many people, they witness this in their homes and they may not understand what is happening. And now we know to take the precautions. We ask Allah to protect everyone from such harm.